born at home until it came out to see you.
Robert.
Mr. Danny, sir. Mr. and Mrs. Danny.
Robert, to your left. Robert, Susan, to your left. Robert.
Robert. Mr. Danny, sir.
Robert, to the head, Robert.
Yeah.
what the Marvel guys have pulled off is pretty incredible. You know, they had this idea to do the individual films over the course of, I don't know, what is it, 8 or 9 years, and then bring them together, and they've done it. And I tell you, walking onto that set with those actors and those characters was one of the best times I've ever had. It's awesome. Oh, there's a lot of action in the film. In between the group, there's quite a bit of conflict, and then outside, you know, once they sort of sort out their differences. But it's a hell of a ride. I mean, I saw it about a month ago actually, and it was just like every fight was there was something bigger and newer and faster, and it's great.
Well, it's exciting, you know. It's a little nerve-wracking having to share the screen with people you look up to and respect so much. But they were great. You know, all the people who are more experienced were very kind and very gentle with us and really made us feel at home. Well, he's just trying to adapt to the way society is now. You know, everyone he knows is dead. It's a different world. It's a different society. And he may have fit in a bit more 70 years ago. So it's about trying to adapt to the way things are now. But I can honestly say, we'll be satisfied. It's a great movie. I just saw it. It's a really good movie. Well, that's just it. You have so many different characters who've managed to strike a balance with everyone. And so you have the humor, and you have the drama, and you have the conflict. It's what these superhero movies need.
We don't see this all the time anymore, the big giant premiere, and it feels appropriate, this movie, the way they set it up with 4 or 5 Origins movies of other superheroes, and then bring them all together. And when I read the script, I thought, I can't believe it. He did it. He found a way to really make it all work and take the story further, and I just felt really lucky to be part of it. You know, Agent Coulson is the regular guy, and at the same time, he's really not. So in some moments, I get to be the guy that someone thinks is a regular guy who turns out to be the keeper of secrets and some terrifying powers. And in other moments, I really get to kind of have the reaction to what's going on and who these people are that the audience is having. And I think it's been a really great experience for me because people really connect with him for that reason.
I think everybody who sees this film will be, at the very least, entertained. Joss Whedon is genius and could not be better suited for this job because he did such a great job at giving all of these very famous superheroes their moments in the film, and also it was so funny. And the special effects, I mean, you know, going in to see a film like this, the special effects are going to be amazing. It's Disney, it's Marvel, it's going to be incredible. But it was, what I found watching it, it was all the superheroes were humanized. You felt after the film like you'd gotten to know them better. And also like the last 30 minutes, I don't think I breathed many times. I know I had to or else I wouldn't be here. But I was just stunned by everything that they were able to capture on screen.
The audience is kind of the other character in the movie, and people have been so kind and warm and receptive to the idea of this kind of complicated guy who winds up in this extraordinary situation. So I don't know. I'm incredibly grateful, you know, to tell you the truth. Well, the real diehard fans, you know, and like the Comic-Con folk and all that, of which I'm kind of one, honorary one, have been wondering and imagining if something like the Avengers would ever happen. So, you know, they get their wish this year. Well, that to me is the real litmus of anything. You know, first and foremost, I'm I buy tickets, I go to movies, I love movies, and I'm critical of movies once I've paid to see them. So I really like it when I get to sit with an audience and get a real reaction.
This sits squarely in the category of enjoying the hell out of myself. I've never done anything quite like this, and I'm really basking in the this historical moment. Honestly, it was very daunting because there's a lot of street cred that you have to come up to in the part, and some really, really great actors have played it in the past, going all the way back to Bill Bixby, and it's a legacy that you have to come with your A game playing. So I was a little freaked out, honestly. People love the Hulk, you know. It's I'm dedicating this performance to my 10-year-old son Keen, who's his own little Hulk, and he's at 10 years old. I think we all have that inside of us, this kind of wild superhuman emotion that wants to come out sometimes, but the world tells us no. You have to behave yourself. You have to be good. You have to do the right thing, and I think for people, they see it and they get to release. It's just, we all love it when he hulks out. I think they're going to see a much more nuanced Hulk. I think it's a more human feeling, you know, not such a difference between the Hulk and Bruce Banner. You know, you could really see Bruce Banner and the Hulk, and I just think, you know, with Josh Whedon's guidance, this is the kind of the pinnacle of comic book movies, and it captures the humor and the fun and the excitement, and all the characters are really cool, and they all get their own little moment in the sun.
It's the first time we actually see what Nick does, how he operates, get a better idea of what his thinking is and what the Avengers initiative actually is and why he wants to put it in motion. Oh, it's great. It's an awesome task because Joss understands the genre so well. And the script was amazing, the characterizations, the interaction between the characters, the relationships and how they're formed, built, and how we come together was brilliantly conceived by him. And it's just an awesome kind of feeling to be in the same room with all those guys at the same time, especially when I get to sort of manipulate them and get them to do my will. It's a lot more exciting than they're going to realize. Like I said, Josh has this great understanding of the genre. So the story itself is full of a lot more than just things blowing up. There's intrigue, there's pathos. You actually at certain times see superheroes who have fear in their eyes because they don't really know what to do or what needs to be done. So it's a very complex story that's played out in a very exciting way.
I have to say the exciting time this go around is that it's the fans have already accepted me as Black Widow, so it's nice to be able to kind of feel like you have a fan base that's already invested in the work that you've done, and you know, they're expecting to see you, they're excited to see you come back, and it's a kind of a little bit of a different feeling. I feel more like a part of the family at this time around than like the maybe like the new stepchild the first time around. I I think audiences can expect exactly what I experienced, hopefully, which is unbelievable excitement. It's a constant adventure. The action is nonstop. And there's also a lot of little kind of fortune cookies for diehard fans in there, I think, that will really appreciate that Joss Whedon just, you know, kind of planted in for those serious fanboys. I love this character. I think she has an amazing backstory, and I think it's very rare that we get to see women in these kinds of either action movies or comic book movies that really are not just the wife or the love interest or something on the side that has nothing to do. The fact is, I get to play a super heroine
Did you see my cameo?
Yes, I did.
Made the movie.
Of course.
And believe it or not, I have not yet seen the movie. I saw my cameo and I said, that's enough. No, actually, they kicked me off the set after I did the cameo. They said, we want you to be surprised. And starring Captain America, Iron Man, the Hulk, and Thor, Hawkeye, the Black Widow, and a lot of other people, all in one movie, all on one magnificent screen, in one fantastic story, and I cannot wait to go in and see it. A half a century ago, when I was writing these, the only thing we thought of was, we hope the books will sell so we can keep our job and pay the rent. And if anybody had said, one day I'll be on the red carpet and I'll be interviewed by a Disney crew, forget it.
It's such a privilege, you know, to be part of something this size, which people just love wholeheartedly, and it's not an intellectual thing, it's a really instinctive, emotional connection people feel, because Marvel is part of people's childhood, I think, and you grow up with these characters and you kind of just love them, and the mythology is almost this massive canvas through which all of our humanity is explored in a strange way. So it's a huge privilege, I'm really excited. He's let go a bit, you know. He's kind of let his hair down, literally and metaphorically. He's given way to his darker instincts. You know, I think in Thor there was a glimmer of redemption in him that you might pull him back from the brink, and if Odin or if Thor had sort of said the right thing, that he would have acquiesced and made peace with them. But in this, he's all out. Anarchic. He's truly an agent of chaos. He's come down to Earth to rule the human race as their king. And what he's desperate for is an identity, because he's always told he was born to rule. And given that he'll never have Asgard and he'll never have Jotunheim, he's going to refashion this planet into his own kingdom. A deeply tragic and misguided intention, but nevertheless, a hell of a lot of fun to play. It's just a riot. I mean, it is, it's just extraordinary. And I say that from inside it. Like, whenever I was on set with everybody, I thought, oh my God, you know, not only am I on set with Robert Downey Jr. and Samuel L. Jackson and Scarlett Johansson and Jeremy Renner, Mark Ruffalo, Chris Evans, Chris Hemsworth, but they're all dressed in capes and flags and armor and iron suits, and the hell is going on. It's like a childhood dream come true. It's more fun than should be allowed, this film. It's just the most incredible roller coaster. A roller coaster because the action is so breathtaking, and I can take no credit for that. But a roller coaster because Joss Whedon's such a brilliant writer. And so he pulls you in, and you're emotionally invested, and then you're laughing, and then you're crying, I hope, and you know, all that. It's great. It's really great.